Yes, I walked to the building. It's good exercise. Gets the breath going, you know, the lungs. Get nice and full, ready for the show tonight. See, I walk. I don't need a car. I need to walk. I can walk.
You know, the most important aspect of my job is teaching. Ring announcing is probably the most important aspect of my job. Ring announcing is the most important, but teaching at 1A, 1B, it's right up there. But yeah, ring announcing is, I guess, like that's my job, right? So ring announcing is the most important aspect, I guess. It's gonna be higher. There we go. Here is your, yeah, there we go. That's the right height right there. That's what you want. You need some height on that, so when it's time to jump up and announce that winner, you gotta be able to spring right off. You know, I'll be honest with you, man. I do this for the connection that I get with the superstars, with the WWE Universe. That's something money can't buy. Actually, to be quite honest with you, I'd do it for free.
So where do we announce you from if you have a singles match?
I'm from Queens.
But with the whole Andrade thing?
That doesn't, because I associate myself with him, I'm all of a sudden Mexican?
No.
What's wrong with you?
I'm just telling you.
Are you
what
like,
they, no! They, listen.
Are you, no, we're just going to rewind that real quick. Listen to my voice. How do you not know where I'm from?
Thanks for
well, I do, when you get the attitude like that, I know. Then I'm like, oh, she's a New Yorker,
it's about,
okay.
It's about to get like 5 times worse. You keep talking like that.
No, I was asking.
Talking about I'm from Mexico.
No, those words never came out of my mouth. I might not do it for free. I have a pretty nice place. Kind of expensive, so like, and I really want to keep that. But I mean, other than that, like, it's about that connection with the superstars. It's not about the money. Like, it's kind of about the money, but like, not really about the money. Does that make sense? It's like, yeah, like I kind of need the money because I don't want to lose my place. My car's paid off though, so you know what I'm saying? Like, I don't need that part of it. Car payment, no. Connection, superstars, WWE Universe. That's where it's at. You know, Albert Einstein once said, strive not to be a success, which I think is totally ridiculous. I mean, what's that about? Of course, no matter what you're doing, you want to strive to be a success. But for some reason...
Greg, I'm sorry. The quote is actually, strive not to be a success, but rather to be a value.
But before you can get to that value part, you need to be successful. Because how valuable are people going to think you are if you're not successful? So I was going to get to that once I finished explaining about the success part. Because I can't get past that, Einstein. Stick to the theory of relativity.
Two texts to both phones and nothing.
What?
I needed help yesterday, and I texted you on both your phones.
You did?
Knowing that you probably wouldn't respond. Because I thought my number never goes through to you.
I seriously didn't get a text from you yesterday.
He blocked me on both of his phones.
No, I seriously didn't. I'm not kidding.
He's the best in the world ring announcer, which is why he doesn't answer my text messages anymore.
I got a text her back? Are you kidding me? Figure it out. It's big leagues, kid. You know, in different professions, everybody has their sort of rituals, their routine, so to speak. I like to sit in every single seat in the arena before the WWE Universe files in and get an idea of in each seat what the WWE Universe will see when I'm in that ring announcing. I would say the best seat in the arena is the one that can see me announcing. You know which seat that is? All of them. A vacuum in the back. There's no vacuums during the show. I'm trying to get this ready. It's like vacuuming anyway. First of all, you want to stay consistent, so you got to do the warm-ups. You know, you go through the tees. It's stuff that you have to do on a daily basis. And you know, part of it is, yeah, man. I want to impress the superstars. I want to give them a unique sound.
WWE Women's Tag Team Champions: Peyton Royce, Billy Kay, the Iconics.
Yeah, iconic.
Show me your best iconic.
Here you go.
From the Queens
City. Charlotte.
Hey, guys.
He is the artist known as Shinsuke Nakamura.
Bray County Wicklow, Ireland, Intercontinental Champion.
You getting your own TV show now?
No, just...
We are really scraping the barrel.
But remember, it's Lee. You want to say it like it's two names.
Lee!
Yeah, so now we're back to two names, see?
You know, I got to tell you, at this point in my career, there's kind of just one person I'm really trying to impress.
Who is that one person?
Shane McMahon. You get him?
Yeah.
People ask me a lot about Shane McMahon, and I guess here's the thing is, like, I think we're cool. You know, we always say hello to each other. He left me a voicemail once. Wait, he needed me to pick something up for him and bring it out to the limo, but he trusted me with that, right? Like, he didn't text anybody else to do that.
This is very important, and you better get this right. Okay? Say it with conviction. And you do it with pride. You understand me? Are you sure? All right.
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing the best in the world!
No. That's not good enough.
Introducing the best in the world!
No. No, God, man, what is the matter with you? Come here.
I understand that people see what they see. On television, they hear the way he talks to me. But you know what you don't see? Is you don't see the way he looks at me. You don't see what his eyes are telling me. Because his eyes are telling me, hey, listen, bro, I got to keep this up for appearances. I got to play this role, but I believe in you, and you're doing a heck of a job. And I know you're going to hit this note, and you and I are boys. So when you watch it on television, he's a little derogatory, a little demeaning towards me at times. Sure, fair enough, but... When you hit a good best in the world and you hold that note and you hold it solid, it's not wavering, and then Shane does the close, and you feel like you nailed it.
The best in the world!
Yeah, there's a little internal fist bump there. My diaphragm and vocal cords are doing a little bit of this. Sure. A lot of pride in that. Don't mean to be rude, but kind of out of time. Got to go start doing the vocal exercises, get the tea, and get warmed up a little bit, get the chords going. Appreciate the camera time. Tell you what, I'll leave you with the Shane O'Mac quote to close it out, right? What's up, Columbus? Gets me every time, dude. He's so good. Where does he come up with this stuff, man? He's so good.
I really hope this helped you a little bit.
Oh, immensely.
Best in the world.
I will never say it like that, but thank you.
Good luck.
See, as you can see here, I usually bring anywhere 40 to 60 ties per week. Maybe we go with the purple tonight. Maybe one of the solid reds. We're in Buckeye country, OHIO. I've only got about 30 minutes, but I've got it narrowed down, though. We're down to about 20.
I would go with one that makes your head look less fat.
Here's the truth, man. Quite humbly, I've been given a gift, right? A golden, golden gift. A golden vocal gift. And I'm kind of obligated to share it with the world. That's why I do this. I don't do it for me. No. That would be selfish. Selflessly. This gift, yeah, it's in my throat, it's in my vocal cords, but it doesn't belong to me. Oh no, this is to be shared with the world and shared with the universe, really, the WWE universe. So, you know, I'd like to think that I'm quite magnanimous and selfless in that way, that's who I'm here for. That's who I do it for, not for me.
Okay. Dude, what are you doing?
Oh, button us up, honestly.
No, I'm just trying to...